lovely learners. Are you ready to read? I know I am. Get comfy. It's listening time. Let's turn up the volume on our ears. Can you hear me now? Sweet. And now since we're listening, we're going to have to turn down the volume on our mouths. On the count of three, we're gonna put on our regal reading glasses so that you can see the pictures, or you can even read along with me if you already know how. Ready? Okay. One, two, three. Wow. Today, we're going to read an excerpt from a collection of stories. This collection of stories is called Trailblazers, the Black Pioneers Who Have Shaped Canada, and it's written by Tiana Ridley Padmore, and the illustrations are by Meryl Royce Nedima Musa. Today, we are going to learn about Rose Fortune. Rose Fortune, she lived from 1774 to 1864. Rose was one of Canada's first entrepreneurs. She started a service at hotels to carry guests' luggage and wake them up so that they wouldn't miss their boats. Some people say that Rose was also Canada's first policewoman. She took it upon herself to enforce laws in her hometown of Annapolis Valley in Nova Scotia. So this here is Rose Fortune. Rose Fortune's parents yearned to be free, and as loyalists found a solution. The family sailed to Canada during the Revolution. Miss Rose Fortune made her name as an entrepreneur of all sorts. She started a wake-up call service and hauled people's luggage from ports. But Rose became widely known and a legend in her time when she took matters into her own hands and started warding off crime. Wearing her felt hat and holding a stick, she patrolled Annapolis town. She fiercely protected her people and made sure the law was laid down. North America's first female constable, though unofficial, her role, Rose Fortune made the streets safer. Being paid was not her goal. No one appointed Miss Fortune. No one told her to be strong. A feminist pre-feminism. Rose and her boldness live on. Wow. So again, this is Rose Fortune. She lived from 1774 to 1864. Wow. Wasn't that an amazing story? Yeah, I think so too. And I don't know about you, but all that reading made me so thirsty. So I'm going to take a sip of water from my clever cup. Delicious. I love reading and learning with you. Your good company brought so much love and light to this room. So lovely learners, we have a dash of love and a sprinkle of light. But what did we learn today? Now that was a great story about entrepreneurship. Do you know what an entrepreneur is? Yes, that's right. It's a person who owns their own business. Good job, lovely learners. You're all so smart. Did you know that a business could be just about anything? From a store to a scientific research center. So cool, isn't it? Rose Fortune's business helped hotel guests by waking them up so that they would not be late for their outings while they were on vacation and staying at the hotel. She also helped them with carrying their heavy bags. What a great idea! Now, businesses always start off as a great idea. And you know what? These ideas are always meant to help other people some way or somehow. Isn't that amazing? Everything that we use comes from a business. Our toothpaste, our cars, or even pet grooming services that help us take care of our cats and dogs. During the time that Rose Fortune lived, Black people and women didn't usually own their own businesses. So it was such a great accomplishment for Rose Fortune to become the first Black woman here in Canada to own her own business. A special Lovely Learner shout out goes out to my girl Kiara, who started her own lemonade stand this past summer. Isn't that impressive? Yeah. It sure is. All of you Lovely Learners are so smart, so I'd really like to hear about your ideas for businesses. If you could start out your own business and become an entrepreneur, what would your idea be? You can always send me an email at the link below, because I'd really love to hear about it.